Good morning, children. Today we are studying the chapter Weather, Climate and Adaptation from Sundala Science. You might have studied the introductory part of the chapter in the previous year. So, weather, climate and adaptations, these are most relevant factors that affect the life of organisms on the earth, including human beings. Now, when we consider the weather, it controls and arrange or adjust the life of organisms, including human beings. It is really unpredictable. Okay? Then what is weather? Weather is a day-to-day changes in the atmosphere at a place with regard to the temperature, rainfall, humidity, speed and direction of the wind. So we can define the weather as the day-to-day changes. Weather are the day-to-day changes in the atmosphere at a place with regard to the temperature, rainfall, humidity, direction and the intensity of the wind. So the weather is a day-to-day change. It will change from hour to hour. What is happening this moment will not be in the next moment. So the weather can change every minute or every hour. It is really unpredictable. Now, there are many factors that affect the weather of the day at a place. These factors that affects the weather at a place is called elements of weather. What are the elements of weather? Temperature, humidity, rainfall, direction and the intensity of the wind. First of all, let us discuss about temperature. You know, temperature is one of the most important factors that affect the distribution of organisms on the earth. The place where there is very high temperature, the people are very less. For example, in different parts of our country, okay, at the Thar desert where the temperature is more, Rajasthan, most of the part of the Rajasthan where the temperature is very high, the organisms including human beings are very less in number. In Sahara desert and many many deserts, you can see the number of humans and other organisms living in that place is comparatively lesser than other places. More organisms, more humans and other animals and organisms live in the what we call tropical region, that is around or in, on either sides of the equator, right? Now the temperature, when we consider the temperature, usually temperature gradually rises from the morning to the afternoon. It is said that the lowest temperature is observed in the early morning of the day, that is between 3 to 4 to 5. Between 3 to 5, we can understand that the temperature is very low. This is called the minimum temperature. Whereas in the afternoon hours, you can see the temperature increases suddenly. So that is called the maximum temperature. So maximum temperature is measured in the afternoon hours and the minimum temperature is in the early morning. How can we measure this minimum and maximum temperature? What are the instruments to measure this temperature? At the present situation, the thermometer is the device to measure the temperature. There are minimum thermometer or minimum temperature thermometer and maximum temperature thermometer. Minimum thermometer and maximum thermometer. Minimum thermometer measures the minimum temperature of the day early morning, whereas maximum temperature can be measured around after 2 o'clock, between 2 and 3 again. The reason for this minimum temperature is measured in the early morning because the sunlight or sun just start rising, and it is very away from, very far away from the equator, that is near the polar sides. It was the sunrise was very slanting during this time, but as the time passes in the afternoon, the sun really at the vertical position above the tropical region. Okay, so that time we can feel more temperature. So minimum temperature is due to the more slanting of the sun's rays falling, and maximum temperature is due to the vertical position, that is very closer, the sun is very closer to the earth. Now the temperature gradually increases from 0 degree to 1, 2, 3 up to 40 degree. Even 40 to 45 degree Celsius temperature has been measured and noted in many parts of our north and east part of our country. Okay, for example, in Kerala, Punallu, the maximum temperature is observed in our country. Sometimes in northern region like Rajasthan, sometimes. Minimum temperature is observed in many hilly region terrains and the Himalayan regions of our country. So anyhow, the temperature is one of the most important factor that affects the weather of a place. Now let's see the humidity. What is humidity? Humidity is the rate of water vapor, the amount of water vapor present in the atmosphere. What is humidity? The amount of water vapor present in the atmosphere is called humidity. So when there is more humidity, we tend to perspire and sweat more, because the humidity can increase the temperature of our body, right? That is another biological phenomenon, how we perspire and sweat more when the humidity is more. So water vapor is not a cool water drops, it is really hot water vapor, that will increase the perspiration and humidity, I mean the sweat. The humidity can be measured by an instrument called a hygrometer. Hygrometer. So how can we measure the humidity of the atmosphere? By using an instrument called hygrometer. Hygrometer is the instrument to measure the humidity. So what is humidity? The amount of water vapor present in the atmosphere. Now the rainfall. We can connect the humidity to the rainfall, because when there is more humidity, there is more chance for rainfall. If there is more humidity, there is more chance for rainfall. In Kerala, many parts you can see the humidity is more. So sweating is more in Kerala. Humidity is more, then there is greater chance for a rain. Here less humidity in north, so less rainfall. In the south, like Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra, then the humidity, there the humidity is more, so there is more rainfall, right? So humidity and rainfall is interrelated. If there is more humidity, more rainfall. Actually, in India, the rain, usually we use rain gauge, rain gauge. RINGAUGE. Rainfall is an instrument used to measure the rainfall. We can, make a rain gauge, temporary rain gauge, by using a bottle. A bottle can be taken, long bottle, lengthwise. Then we can level, we can gauge it in centimeters. Okay, we can measure. Then you keep it in the open space. When it rains continuously for a particular time, particular period, we can note down how much rainfall or rain is collected, rainwater is collected in this rain gauge. In a particular day when there is more rain, or the whole day, whatever it is. In 24 hours, in 12 hours, how much rain fell, okay, rainwater fell on the earth. That can be measured simply by using the rain gauge that we can make in our home, in the laboratory, and we can measure the rainfall. It is usually measured. Rain is usually measured in, centimeters. But in millimeter also it is possible. Millimeter rain, centimeter rain. So millimeter measurement is very difficult in our homemade rain gauge. But laboratory made rain gauge is an commercial rain gauge. Has this millimeter and the centimeter digits. Okay, we have rain gauge is an instrument used to measure the rainfall. So humidity and rainfall is interconnected, I said. Rain. What are the two sources of rain? In India, there are two times we get the rain. June to September, we call it southeast monsoon. Southeast monsoon. Okay? June to September. This southeast monsoon, southeast monsoon. Or southwest monsoon. Southwest monsoon. That comes in the month of June to September. Actually, this southwest monsoon is due to the heavy wind that is blown from Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean. During this southwest monsoon, in the month of June to September, the wind blown from the moist or humid or moist laden wind coming from the Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean blows to our country, and that brings southwest monsoon throughout our country. So this is the most important monsoon, southwest monsoon. And which month it happens? June to September. What is the reason? The moist laden wind coming from the Bay of Bengal and the Indian Ocean. Clear? It's very clear. Now the second monsoon comes. We can say they comes usually in the month of, you can see, September to November to March. November to March. That is called the northeast monsoon. So northeast monsoon comes really now from November till March. And this rain is really somewhat cool rain because of the winter season, and wind carries the cool moisture, cool drops of water drops from different parts of the ocean. That is what is northeast monsoon. But in summer season, actually this northeast monsoon happens in winter. You can understand that. Winter. And southwest monsoon is not in the winter, it is in the summer. Okay? It is happening in the summer also. Okay? Now, in summer, the hot air blown from Rajasthan to Delhi bring hot air and making the Delhi hotter. Which month? In summer season, particularly May month. Okay? April, May month. So, these are the two sources of rain in our country, southwest monsoon and northeast monsoon. Southwest monsoon usually comes or begin in summer and continues till September. Right? Now, northeast monsoon in winter. So anyhow, the Indian Ocean and the Bay of Bengal play very important role. The moist laden wind from Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean play very important role in this monsoon in our country. Right? So it is very interesting that predicting the weather. Is it easy to predict the weather? It is not easy to predict the weather because the weather is a day-to-day changes in the atmosphere, hour-to-hour changes in the atmosphere. It is influenced by many factors. Not only these four factors, temperature, humidity, rainfall and the winds. There are many other, local factors that affect the weather of a place. So, considering these hundreds of factors into account, predicting weather, who by meteorologist, meteorologists predict the weather. It's not easy task. So many a time the prediction of the weather may go wrong because the weather is day to day changes. It changes from time to time, and it has to be taken hundreds of factors, many factors in account. So most of the time the prediction of the weather may go wrong, but we can say that around 50% of the time the weather prediction would be correct. So who predict the weather? Meteorologist. So this is all about the weather. So what is weather? What are the factors affecting weather? We call the elements affecting the weather: temperature, humidity, rainfall, and the direction and intensity of the wind. Okay. Now predicting weather is not easy, as it has to be taken hundreds of factors into account. So almost all the time, the prediction of the weather may go wrong. Right. Now, what are the two sources of rain in our country? Southwest monsoon that comes in the month of June to September, and then in summer northeast monsoon. What is the role of the ocean in developing this rain or monsoon? Yes, Indian Ocean and Bay of Bengal. Indian Ocean and Bay of Bengal influence the southwest monsoon. The moist laden air, the water laden air from Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean during this June to September bring heavy rain. That is called the southwest monsoon throughout our country. Okay. So now the last climate. Climate is unlike the weather. Climate is a long term average of the weather. Long term average of the weather, say about 25 years, what is the weather of a place? You will take the average of the weather conditions of a place, say about 25 years. So the average of the weather conditions of a place is around 25 years. We call the climate. So in this part we have studied the weather, the elements of our weather: temperature, humidity, wind, rainfall. Who is meteorologist? Why prediction of weather may go wrong? Because of the many reasons. What is the rain gauge? And what are then what are the two sources of rain in our country? These are the introductory part of this chapter.